Hi children, now let's continue with the same activity. See here, I have taken a triangle and I have made copy of the same triangle twice. So I have three copies of the same triangle. It means that all these three measures, angle AAA, all these measurements are equal because it is a trace of the one. So all the three angles will be equal in all the three triangles. Is it clear? Now see here, I am arranging it. This is A and here I have B and here I have C. What do I get if I add A, B and C? Do I get a straight line or not, my dear children? Yes, we get a straight line. What is the angle that I have together if I add A, B and C? Yes, it is 180 degree. That is sum of angle A, angle B and angle C is 180 degree. And see, one more activity I have for you. Here I have three angles, isn't it? I tear off all these three angles. And now I again rearrange it. Angle A, angle B and angle C. Again, what do I get? I get a straight line. Do I get a straight line? Yes. What is the angle at this point where all the three angles are added? It is 180 degree. Just now I showed you, no? This is full angle is 180 degree. Again, one more activity. See here. I have the same triangle. I am drawing a perpendicular line across this vertex A. To have that perpendicular line, I am folding it and I am making a trace of it. See, this is the perpendicular line. Now, I fold it at this point. What angle is there now? Are you able to see? It is angle A. It is upside down because I have written in that order. Okay, it is A. Now, see here. I am joining angle B along with A. Yes, it is angle B. Now I am joining again angle C. What do I get again? If I add A, B and C, I get again 180 degree. And this property is called as angle sum property of a triangle. See, this is what we did as the first activity. Yes, the next is what I torn and I arranged it. Then I folded it. We get all the angles added together to get 180 degree. So at home, you are going to draw three triangles and it is an activity in your textbook. A, B, C, P, Q, R and X, Y, Z. And you are going to measure the angle A, angle B, angle C for one triangle. You will add it and see what you get. And similarly, you will add angle P, angle Q and angle R in another triangle PQR. Let all the three triangles be of different shape. So that you will get a clear idea what should be done. Okay, children. And this is the angle sum property. Now, it is stated as, if they ask you to state the angle sum property of a triangle, you have to state like this. The total measure of all the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. That's what we have seen so far within different activities. The total measure of all the three angles. If I add up all the three angles in a triangle, it is equal to 180 degree. Is it clear, my dear children? So let us solve few problems based on this property. Here they have given a diagram. It is a triangle and they are asking us to find the angles of a triangle. I have to find what angle, what is the measure of this angle, here this angle and this angle. Have they given any measurement for this angle? Just by looking at a glance, you may say, no ma'am, there is no measurement. But they have given, my dear children, here this is 90 degree. This perpendicular symbol indicates that this measurement is 90 degree. Is it clear? So, by angle sum property, we have the sum of all these three angles, X, 2x and 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. You have to state the property why you write this line. X plus 2x plus 90 is equal to 180. How do we write this? It is angle sum property. Okay. Now 1x plus 2x is, if there is no number before a variable, it means that we have 1 there. Okay. So 1x plus 2x is 3x. 3x plus 90 is equal to 180. Now I will transpose this 90 to this side and I get 180 minus 90, which is equal to this 3x as it is. Then if we have 3x is equal to 180 minus 90 is 90. I will transpose this 3 to this side. I get 90 by 3. So what is x? It is 30 degree. So if this x is 30 degree, what is 2x? 2 into 30 degree. So what is 230, sir? Yes, very good. It is 60 degree. And this is 90 degree. Now add and see whether you get a 180 degree. Yes, this is 90. Again, this 2 becomes 90. So 90 plus 90 is a 30 degree. What type of triangle is it? All three angles are different. Yes, it is a scalene triangle. Is it clear? And also acute angled triangle. Right angled triangle. It is 90 degree now. So we will say it is as a right angled triangle. So therefore the angles are 30, 60 degree and 90 degree. Hope it is clear, my dear children. Shall we move to the next? Yes, here is a question for you. How will you find x and y now? Dear children, here is one property that you will learn in previous chapter. But we have skipped that chapter and next I will teach you that chapter. There you will learn about a special angle called vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Always whenever we have two lines intersecting, two lines meeting, we will get vertically opposite angles. These two angles will always be equal in whichever way they intersect. If it is this way also, these two angles will be equal. If I have some parallel lines and again I have a transversal, here this angle and this angle will be equal. This angle will be equal. Vertically opposite angles will be equal. Here this angle and opposite. Here if these two are vertically opposite, the other pair is here this one and this one. Is it clear? These are called as vertically opposite angles. With that content, we get the value of y is equal to 80 degree. Y is equal to 80 degree. Why? It is because they are vertically opposite angles. Now use the property that we have learnt. What is the property that we learnt today? Yes, angle sum property of a triangle. With that we write x plus y plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. What is y? Just now we found the value, no? Yes, it is 80 degree. So x plus 80 plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. If I add these two, I get 130. If I transpose this, I get 180 minus 130, which is equal to 50 degree. So what is the value of x? It is 50 degree. What is the value of y? 80 degree. Now add and see whether we get 180 as the sum of all the three angles in a triangle. Yes, we do get it. Is it clear? Okay, now next question here. Full of x and y. No numbers. No measure of angle is given. Can we find it? Try, children. Come on. Think how to find. I have taught you three properties. One is exterior angle, one is angle sum property, and one is vertically opposite angles. Which among these three, which two properties you are going to use it? Vertically opposite angles are equal. Very good. See, here these two lines intersect. So this also is x equal to x. What about this angle? Yes, it is vertically opposite to this x. So again, this is also x. Here, what is the angle here? Again, this is x. Because these two are vertically opposite angles. Am I clear now? Now we got all the angles in a triangle. What are they? X, X, X. So I can say by angle sum property, x plus x is equal to 180. 3x is equal to 180. If I transpose this 3, it comes in the denominator 180 by 3. So x is equal to 60 degree. Again, y is also 60 because y is equal to x. They have just given this letter Y to confuse us. But you should be smart. Okay, just think and do it. So we got all these three angles to be equal. So what type of triangle it is? Very good. It is equilateral triangle. As all the angles are acute angle, we can also say this angle triangle as acute angled triangle also. Is it clear, my dear children? Okay. Shall we move to the next? Okay. Two angles here. So far they gave shape of a triangle. Find X and Y. Here they have not given any diagram. They have given in just words. So most of the time in exam you will get questions where you are supposed to draw the diagram. They will not give diagram. After reading the question, you have to draw the diagram and find the answer. Okay, two angles of a triangle. So there is a triangle. Okay, two angles are 30 degree and 80 degree. So this is 30 degree and this is 80 degree. Find the other third angle. So what property am I going to use now? Yes, very good. Angle sum property. So by angle sum property, we have 30 plus 80 plus x. We don't know this third angle. So I name it as x, which is equal to 180. This 80 plus 30 is 110. If I subtract, I get 70 degree. So what is the third angle? It is 70 degree. Is it clear? Okay, now next question is, the three angles of a triangle or in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 1. See, again ratio. So I have a triangle. They have given the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 1. So what are the original measure? Yes, very good. It will be 1x. Another one will be 2x. Another one again it will be 1x. Just by looking at it, can you say with this itself, can you say what type of triangle it is? Yes, it is going to be isosceles triangle, because these two angle measures the same. If two angles are same, the measure of two sides will also be same, will be equal. Okay, two angles are equal, two sides will also be equal. So it is an isosceles triangle. Now I have to find the angles of a triangle. Again, the same property. By angle sum property, I can have x plus 2x plus x. See, I have drawn a diagram here. You are supposed to draw a diagram neatly and not like this. Use your scale, pencil and draw neatly. Okay, x plus 2x plus x is equal to 180 degree. So 2x, here 1x, 3x plus 1x, 4x. Hope you understood how we got 4x here. 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 4x, which is equal to 180 by 4. If I cancel it, 1 4 is 4, 4 4 is 16, remainder 2, if I combine with 0, I get 20, so I have 5 4 is 20, so 45 degree. So these two angles are going to be 45 degree. So in an isosceles triangle, the base angles will be 45 degree. If two angles are 45 degree, automatically the other angle will be 90 degree, and again it is a right angled triangle also. So this is a special triangle which is also an isosceles triangle as well as a right angled triangle. Okay. Okay, children. And here are the few points that you are going to answer me now. Are you ready? Okay. Can you have a triangle with two right angles? I repeat. Can you have a triangle? Can I draw a triangle with two right angles? What is right angles? It is 90 degree. With two 90 degree, can I have a triangle? See, if there is one 90 degree, it will come straight. Again, another 90 degree. Will I be able to form a triangle? No. It is not possible to have a triangle with such condition. Can you have a triangle with two obtuse angle? Surely not. Obtuse angle is greater than 90. With 90 itself, I cannot make a triangle. How can I make a triangle with two obtuse angles? So it is not possible. Again, we have no here. Can you have a triangle with two acute angles? Think and say. Yes, we can have a triangle with two acute angles. See, my dear children, I will not ask the same.